Whether tomorrow's flakes melt on contact or actually accumulate, Eric Hansen explains there's another factor to consider, our short summer. Eric?
Yeah, Kevin, when we got several inches of snow back in May, the grass was green, and now 10 days before Halloween, it is still green, leading some to believe this summer we're getting shortchanged.
Fairweather duffers would say putting in stocking caps is crazy. If so, call the guys in long johns toting propane heaters in their carts guilty.
Get in the cart, throw the ball down, and hack it down the fairway. Keep moving.
The Marshalltown diehards are feeling shortchanged.
Yeah, I'm kind of down and out a little bit.
Because
as long as there's no snow on the ground, you can come.
And flakes are possible tomorrow.
That looks good.
2 months earlier than last year's first inch.
I was kind of hoping we'd be playing, you know, past Thanksgiving. Uh-huh. Maybe sneak one in around Christmas.
It was just 24 weeks ago that a guy in Roland used his mower to prove how ridiculous it was to get several inches in May.
I'm going to do something stupid, just for fun, for something to remember.
His late spring shenanigans went viral. Today, Marshalltown mowers were taking the top off before fall's first flakes drop. But across the yard, Doug Wilkening's blazer and blade are ready to roll.
I enjoy plowing and just getting out in it.
It's unlikely we'll get that much, but summer lovers are realistic.
Oh, I hope you got that one.
Some are just shorter than others.
Being in Iowa, it's crazy. You never know what's going to happen, you know.
And until they get kicked off,
on to the next hole.
Bob, Doug, and their heaters are pushing on.
And it's not just perceptions either. If we would get an inch of snow here tomorrow, we would shatter the record for the shortest summer break without snow, only 171 days. In comparison, that's 4 months less than it was last year when we went from February to December without snow. That's quite a bit.